Today we are celebrating the Snan Yatra of Lord Jagannath. Every year in Jagannath Puri, on a full moon day, which is considered to be appearance day of Lord Jagannath, there is a grand Abhishekam, or bathing ceremony, held just in the courtyard of the temple of Jagannath. What is important about these festivals is not simply the form in ritual in which it is celebrated, but the spirit in which the devotees express their love and devotion to the Supreme Lord. We are living at a time that is called the Kali Yuga, when people are spiritually very lazy and unfortunate, where life becomes so superficial and spiritually hollow that the world is plagued with hypocrisy and quarrel. So the Lord is so kind that he has appeared within this age as the golden avatar, the Yuga avatar, Lord Chaitanya, not only to teach the pure principles of the essence of spirituality, but to practically exhibit it by his own example. So to understand really what is Snan Yatra, it is important to study how Lord Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu celebrated it with his devotees. In Sri Chaitanya Charitamrita, it is described that the Lord had just returned from traveling 2 years in South India, where he was delivering, without discrimination, all classes of men and women by giving them Krishna's holy names. The name of Krishna is none different than the Lord. The name of Krishna has the power to purify the heart of one who chants the holy name with sincerity, under proper guidance. When he returned to Puri, just coming was the Snan Yatra celebration. Lord Chaitanya and his associates entered into the courtyard early that morning. Baladev, Subhadra, and Jagannath were being bathed profusely with the Panchagavya, Panchamrita, and sanctified waters. Lord Chaitanya was overwhelmed with spiritual happiness to see the Lord being served in such a wonderful way. This is the heart of bhakti. Janmadyasayataha, Krishna, the Supreme Lord, is the root of everything and everyone that exists. When we please Krishna, we find true satisfaction. So that is what Snan Yatra is about. Krishna has so kindly appeared, according to an ancient system given in the scriptures and authorized by great acharyas, in the form of the deities of Balaram, Subhadra, and Jagannath. And they are being glorified. In the heat of the summer, they're being bathed with the most cooling and soothing substances. And thousands of people are chanting their glories and witnessing their beauty. And when devotee sees how Krishna is being satisfied, the devotee finds ecstasy in their heart. Srila Prabhupada explains, as you become purified, when you decorate the deity with nice clothes, you lose the desire to decorate yourself because you're satisfied. When you feed wonderful foods to Krishna, you're happy seeing Krishna eating nicely. We don't need to make so many special arrangements for ourselves. The ecstasy of the heart was exhibited by Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu as he was seeing Krishna, Lord Jagannath, being so beautifully glorified and bathed with wonderful substances and offered hundreds and hundreds of preparations to eat. And that bathing ceremony went on all day. And at the end, Lord Jagannath goes into seclusion. Anabhasara. Prabhupada says, quote unquote, that it is said that Jagannath gets fever from the all day taking baths in public. And for about 15 days, the Dayatapatis, the special servants of the Lord, descendants of Vishwavasu, they perform this service in seclusion. The public cannot see the deity at that time. So Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, to the same degree, he was finding great happiness in seeing the blessed pleasure of the Lord, he was feeling separation,
Vipralamba.
The same separation of the gopis for Krishna when Krishna was separated from them, he would feel when he could not see Lord Jagannath.
When Lord Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu was feeling the ecstasy of separation from Jagannath, he would come here, Alarnath, every year.
Srila Prabhupada explains that Krishna is bhavagrahi. That means he does not accept what you offer him. He accepts the purpose, the motive in which a thing is offered. There are many examples of this. Snan Yatra is a glorious festival where for the pleasure of Baladev, Subhadra and Jagannath, hundreds of devotees will chant their glories, bathe them in wonderful abhishekam, most auspicious substances, honor them and worship them, and all the devotees, if we really try to participate by offering our love, our devotion, by finding happiness in Krishna being glorified, in Krishna's pleasure, we become purified. Actually, if we have the proper consciousness during this Snan Yatra, our hearts are bathed and cleansed of ego and all of its attachments by the sentiment of servitude and the chanting of the holy names. This is essence of how we can approach this beautiful festival of Snan Yatra. Srila Prabhupada has so kindly given us the gift of such an exciting and beautiful culture where everything is directed toward cleansing our hearts and awakening our eternal, essential love for God, Krishna.
You are listening to Radhanath Swami on thesacredconnect.com.